Right, thanks everyone. And we are really, really happy to have Alexander Zimmermann with us, CEO and founder of Solib Informatics. And he's going to discuss this morning objectives, goals, and strategic initiatives, and the way how strategic planning software helps to make better decisions. Alexander, thank you very much, and it's your turn.
Carsten, thank you very much. And hello to everybody. My name is Alexander Zimmermann and I am CEO of Solib Informatik. Today, I would like to show you how to develop strategic goals and measures in a systematic and time-saving fashion. I'd like to do that based on the following example. Let's say there is a company which currently generates a turnover of 60 million euro per year. Its current operating result is 600,000 euro and it has 50 active customers. And up to this point, no activities have been undertaken to gain opinion leadership in the organization's business field. So now the company can either continue as it has so far, that's what we call the base case. And the base case projections in our example are 5% growth per year. Or it can develop a vision for the future and measures how to accomplish it. That's what we want to look at here. So, all right, the first step would be to develop strategic goals. Goals can be hard or soft. Hard goals always include figures. They are very specific and they are measurable. In our example, the company has set itself the following hard goals: to generate a turnover of 250 million euro, to achieve an operating result that amounts to 10% of the turnover, and to expand its customer portfolio to 200 active customers. So soft goals, on the other hand, do not include figures. They are descriptive and less easy to measure. In our example, a soft goal is to gain opinion leadership in the company's field of activity. And in addition, goals may be set, of course, by the management or maybe by the shareholders. The next step now is to perform a comprehensive strategic analysis using various known tools such as market and trend and competitor analysis. The results can then be aggregated and shown in a SWOT analysis. So, based on the aggregated analysis, it is now possible to select those strategic challenges that may have an impact on the company's ability to achieve its goals. In our example, the greatest challenges are gaining international customer awareness, achieving market entry in core countries, increasing the level of international customer awareness, and developing an out-of-the-box product. So focusing on the key challenges will lead to considerable time savings in the subsequent planning process. So the next step is to develop initiatives for each of the identified strategic challenges. This includes descriptions of measures to be taken as well as forecasts and assessments of the expected benefits, the financial impact, and the feasibility of the initiatives. All initiatives developed are then combined into a portfolio. And they are ranked according to their financial impact and feasibility. The portfolio helps to identify the initiatives best suited to meet the strategic goals. In other words, it allows to systematically filter out those initiatives that are not in the green area. In this way, a package of promising initiatives can be put together. In our example, the highest ranked initiatives are the adjustment of the production, product marketing, and the creation of additional distribution channels. So finally, the package of initiatives as a whole needs to be assessed as to whether it is sufficient in meeting the strategic goals. In our example, the total financial impact of the initiative developed 234 million euro, which is below the set goal of 250 million euro. Now the company has two options. It can either develop new and or additional initiatives, or it can change the goals if they prove to be unrealistic. In business practice, however, the latter seems to be less common. You may also want to compare the expected annual growth with and without initiatives. In our example, the results are quite striking. The estimated turnover by 2017 when implementing the initiatives is more than 3 times higher than with a base case scenario. So as you can see, developing strategic goals and measures is really, really worth the effort. So learn more about how strategic planning software can help you with this by visiting our website at www.solip.com. Thank you very much.